So, since my last Hackintosh questions and answers, tips and tricks video, I collected a lot of new information which will help you to build a perfect Hackintosh and simply make your life with Hackintosh easier. So, here it is. Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonau.cloud and I help people with Apple computers, Hackintosh builds, Linux servers, simply overall with computers. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. First, I'd like to talk about BIOS, because correct BIOS version and settings are mandatory for running perfect stable Hackintosh build. In my videos about BIOS settings, I said, update your BIOS and if it will cause issues, then downgrade. It was in time when I was not yet providing BIOS update files and BIOS presets. Now I provide them for all my builds, so I don't recommend to update BIOS whenever a new version is released. Nice example is on Gigabyte Z370 Gaming 5 motherboard. If you will update BIOS to the newest one, your Hackintosh will not work even with correct BIOS settings and super tweaked EFI. At the moment of shooting this video, newest version is F14. But from my hard and long testing, latest great working version is F10. Latest BIOS will completely brick your Hackintosh. So, never underestimate correct BIOS version. Simply not all versions are good for Hackintosh. Another problem relating to BIOS. People often forget most modern motherboards have two chips. That means two BIOSes. One main and second one is backup BIOS. Unfortunately, on most motherboards, there is no switch which you could easily use to select which BIOS you want to boot. Motherboard itself decides which one will boot. Most of the time, it will boot the main BIOS, but in cases like often crashes, wrong memory placement or settings, when simply computer refuses to boot, it will boot from the backup one, but you will not notice it. So, even if you flashed correct BIOS version and set correctly BIOS settings, it can happen your computer will not work, because it simply booted from the backup BIOS, which has completely different BIOS version and settings. So, I always recommend, at first place, check in BIOS which BIOS version is booted. So, if you flash your BIOS with F6 BIOS version and you will later see it booted any other version, then it's clear it booted from the backup BIOS. So, I would immediately flash also this backup one to the desired BIOS version. So, it can never happen again, the BIOS will boot different BIOS version. Main BIOS and the backup one will be the same. Also, a lot of problems with the non-working Hackintosh is related to wrong memory placement. I always ask those people, are you sure you installed your memory correctly? And everybody always answer, sure, I'm not idiot. And they are pissed off at me why I ask so stupid question. But in fact, after a lot of further testing and investigation, I really diagnosed the problem with a problem with memory placement. Unfortunately, those people never apologize to me or say thanks. Very frustrating. Another problem is related to using Apple keyboards. And I'm not just talking about Apple Bluetooth keyboards, also about wired USB Apple keyboards. Bluetooth ones will not work until macOS will load, so you cannot use them to operate in BIOS. You need USB one. But even USB Apple keyboards I cannot recommend for that. Always have lying near your computer some ordinary, even super cheap, crappy PC USB keyboard. That's the best if you need to tweak something in BIOS. But when I don't count BIOS, all Apple wired and Bluetooth keyboards are working absolutely great in Hackintosh. Maybe you can notice I use them all around here. People also very often ask me how to upgrade to the newest major macOS version, so from macOS Mojave to macOS Catalina, for example. So answer is easy. I never recommend to upgrade. While on a lot of systems it will proceed fine, on a lot of systems not. Also, mostly because people have really a lot of mess in their system and have no idea how to update bootloader and kernel extensions. I made whole dedicated video to update, so watch it. I always recommend clean installation. And now I hear those people again, but I have all my software perfectly set up already. I just want to use the migration assistant. So again, you will transfer also that mess from your old system. And don't forget, Migration Assistant will not in all cases transfer all necessary apps files. Simply, if you don't want troubles, do always clean installation, period. Speaking of macOS Catalina, I really have no idea why are people so much obsessed with Catalina. It's not ready yet. For production use, I absolutely don't recommend to switch to Catalina. I will come back to test Catalina when it's going to be at least at 10.15.4 version or higher. Even a lot of real Mac users have huge problems. A lot of software will not work anymore. Even stupid Adobe Suite or latest native Apple Compressor app is using still 32-bit components. You can easily check yourself what apps on your system are using 32-bit components. Navigate to the top left Apple, About this Mac, Software, and Legacy Software. Here you can see everything what will not work when you will switch now to macOS Catalina on your Hackintosh. Also, I see still a lot of people asking me about the dual boot with Windows 10, despite I made whole dedicated video about it. First, people, watch my videos. There's everything you need in it. I don't have thousands of videos yet, so you don't need to spend much time with it. A lot of people are arguing, I have working dual boot for a long time and never had any problems. Sure, I also had no problems until one day it simply happened and Windows killed everything around. Don't forget, there is no way how to disable Windows updates completely. Even if you do all those registry tweaks, debloating, disable everything, from time to time, Windows will still win this game over you. The only safe way how to run Windows side by side with any other operating system is only on a virtualization server. I made whole video about it. And to build such a server, it's for people very easy process and will work on most current computers, if it's not too much low spec, sure. I do virtualization servers for people every day. So if you want such a server, reach me at my Patreon, link is in this video description below. A lot of people ask me what is the name of the application I am using in my videos to test the video encoding H.264 and HAVC H.265 acceleration. So, this application is called VideoProc and it's really very useful and powerful application. It will not just tell you if your encoding acceleration on your computer is working well or not. It's also really very fast video converter between numerous video formats. Let's have a look. I'll take one of my source footage from my videos shot in ProRes 422 10-bit and let's quickly convert it to, for example, iPad. It's using available hardware video acceleration to speed up all conversions. But inside of this app is also a very useful video downloader. So you can download any video from most of popular platforms like YouTube, Vimeo, Facebook, Vivo, and many more for future offline viewing. You can download VideoProc directly from videoproc.com website and take advantage of their 14-day trial, and they offer even 30-day money-back guarantee. So if you want single application for easy and fast converting of your videos or downloading them from internet, this is the app to go with. I can only recommend it. I use it personally quite often. Another very common mistake people do is this one. People see all my recommended parts list in video descriptions and buy quite all of that. But they see, for example, the best motherboard I recommend for Hackintosh, the Gigabyte Z390 Designare motherboard, is $270. But some other board is $30 cheaper. Okay, I will buy the cheaper one. And then they start to complain it's not working. Oh God, you cannot buy anything you want and expect it will work. That's why I made all of that insane investigation already for you, so you don't need to. I spent dozens of money and time on buying a lot of hardware, then again dozens of time on testing all of that and selecting best compatible components. Then I made video about those Hackintosh builds. I gave to people EFI configurations, tweaked for those exact builds. I gave to people correct best BIOS version update files and also correct BIOS setting files. It really cannot be easier. But what I get? Complaints. This and this is not working. In my experience, 99% of problems with Hackintosh are not related to Hackintosh at all, but to user error. Constantly, for example, people complain about my GPU is not working. You said in your video it will work 100% perfectly. So after a long investigation, I find out he did not connect the second 8-pin power cable to the GPU. This is very often problem. Again, those people will never apologize to me. Another very common problem is people will download all my tweaked files and apply them, but it's not working. Okay, why? Because people wanted to save some money and bought cheaper GPU, for example. It's no problem. You can buy cheaper GPU if your intent is to build Hackintosh for music production and you don't need, in that case, any fancy super duper Radeon 7. Of course, but don't forget, tweaked EFI for Vega GPUs or Radeon 7 will of course not work with RX 580. You would need to do some changes in that EFI. So RX 580 will work without problem, but not with EFI tweaked for Radeon 7. I tweak those EFIs daily for people. Simply contact me and I will prepare EFI exactly for your hardware component setup. There's nothing easier for you. Also, very often mistake is people use their USB stick installer with macOS to install the system and then reuse the same disk for anything else. Then those people try to fix something in their configuration and mess up completely their bootloader. Bang! Problem. Think about the original macOS installer USB stick as a Swiss Army knife or lifesaver. If you will keep it, it will let you at any time boot your broken system back and you can repair what you messed up. Easy like this. Broken system up and running in 2 minutes. Another problem is following my advices. If you think you will do 99% of what I advise and it will be running great, then you are wrong. Perfect and 100% working Hackintosh is about to be precise and about to follow exactly all my advices. If you miss single step, it will not work. So even with the best EFI configuration in universe, you have no chance to have perfect Hackintosh if you don't follow advices carefully and precisely, and not just 99%, but 100%. I have daily dozens of people bombarding me about problems. Most common is they simply don't do exactly what I say. Their problem. With my instructions, even absolute newbie can build a perfect Hackintosh in under 30 minutes. But believe it or not, a lot of people even have no idea how to update BIOS or load BIOS preset. So they don't do it and then complain it's not working. If you don't know anything about computers, okay, everybody is good at something else. No problem, I will help you. But you have to tell me you don't know it. When someone wants to build a Hackintosh, I simply assume he or she have some even basic knowledge about PC computers. It's like you wish to be a rocket science engineer, but you cannot count 1 plus 1. Or if you'd like to be a Porsche racing driver right now, but you never drove a car. So, never forget, all my tweaked files like correct BIOS version, correct BIOS settings and tweaked EFI works in conjunction with each other. One without the other will not work correctly. I have one master of universe who made following my tutorial how to fix iMessage, which contains only 5 simple steps, 17 mistakes. Yes, 17 mistakes in just 5 simple steps. So if you are not able to follow 100% precisely my videos or tutorials, which I, by the way, far the best, precise and easiest to understand, then better forget about Hackintosh. Because tutorials from others are complicated for everyone, you would have absolutely no chance. And also, very important notice. People ask me daily, do video about motherboard XYZ, test GPU XYZ, and so on. Oh God, listen, I'm not sponsored by anyone in hardware industry. I don't want to be a slave of anybody. I'm really not a millionaire, and I really cannot and of course will not invest into buying all components on planet just because you want some video about it. I would do it if you would support me in my work. Link to my PayPal donations is in each of my video descriptions, but unsurprisingly, nobody is using it. Everybody wants everything right now and for free. Okay, so try to go to some car dealer and say, I want this car right now and for free, I think in better case they will kick your butt into pieces. So why you expect I will do it? It's easy. Support me in my work and you will get more videos, more builds, more reviews, more advices. I saved to people millions already, but quite nobody said thanks to me by donation. Really very ugly world. So big thanks goes to that tiny amount of those smart and grateful people who really value my hard work and donate it. And please, don't ask me, will this or this work? It may or also may not work. I recommend to my audience strictly only components I personally tested and verified. You should value my approach, because everything I recommend is proven by myself as well as thousands of others. It will work 100%. I don't trust anybody, anything anymore. You can read dozens of stuff on internet. People claiming this or that is working great. But is it really true? Most people on those Hackintosh forums are only massaging their egos, but they will never help you if you will get into troubles. Of course, there is only a tiny fraction of those real developers standing behind the development of bootloaders, patches, extensions, and so on. Those people deserve your attention, and in best case also donation. So trust to those, but not to those 99.9% of arrogant egoists on forums. So I would absolutely avoid forums like Olarela, Tonimac, Reddit Hackintosh forum. Speaking of Olarela, I made 2 videos about how to build the Olarela Hackintosh without a Mac, using just Windows. I hardly promoted their site and brought to them dozens of thousands of customers. But Olarela team, instead of at least saying thanks to me, started lying campaign all over internet, spreading lies, and I get also very serious threats. By the way, Apple took those 2 of my videos down and punished my YouTube channel heavily for 6 months. So stay away from those forums. I don't like ungrateful dumbheads. Another problem. From approximately 30 comments, about 5 of those comments are about the same. Some of my videos have thousands of comments, so imagine how much time daily I should spend answering all the time the same. Why do you think I should answer each one when I answered the same question comments dozens times already? Don't be lazy, don't take my time, take your time and read comments. In most cases, your questions was already answered really a lot of times there. And don't forget, overall the most important rule is, don't repair what ain't broken. I see every day people broke their installations because they simply wanted to upgrade something like bootloader, some kernel extensions and so on, despite their system was running perfectly fine. They simply saw new version is available, so they decided to upgrade. Don't do it unless you want to fix something specific non-working in your system. Is your system working? Great, so don't mess with it. If you want to get answer to your specific question, feel free to comment down below. Maybe I will cover exactly your question in my next video of this series. If you would need some help with Apple Mac, Linux, Windows computer, BSD, server for virtualization, ZFS file server, video editing, fine-tuning your workflow or just consulting, you can always get my personal individual support on my Patreon or Subscribestar. Links are again in this video description below. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button and share this video with your friends so it can help to more people. Don't forget to subscribe to both of my YouTube channels and hit the bell next to it so you will get notifications about my new videos. You can also visit my Facebook, Twitter, Reddit or my website. Morgonaut is always here to help. And of course, don't forget to watch my other videos. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Hackintosh friends.